Hello and welcome to this video. Today we are going to discuss the change of coordinate matrix. As a simple example, assume we are in R2 and in blue is our standard basis E1, E2, and we call this basis beta. However, we know that the basis is not unique. For example, these two vectors, V1 and V2, also constitute a basis. They are linearly independent and they span the whole space R2. We will call this basis beta prime, and it consists of two vectors, V1 and V2. An important role of a basis is that, given a basis for each element of the space, we can write a coordinate vector. For example, for this vector V, which is in green, we can write that this is 4 times the first basis vector in beta plus 2 times the second basis vector in beta, and therefore we can write that the coordinates of this vector in beta are 4, 2, where the numbers 4 and 2 correspond to these coefficients. And we can do this for any basis. So now my question to you is, what will be the coordinates of V in the basis beta prime? Think about it, and then we will discuss this together. Our vector V is 4, 2, and now we can write it as a linear combination of the vectors in beta prime, and that will be 1 times 1 minus 1 plus 3 times 1, 1. You can check it very easily that this is correct, and then these two numbers are the coordinates. So the coordinates of this vector in the basis beta prime are 1 and 3, where again 1 and 3 are coming by definition from this linear combination. You can ask yourself, how did I guess this linear combination? This is illustrated here in the figure, and in this particular case it was not very difficult to just guess. But you can imagine that in more complicated spaces and with more complicated bases, it will not be very easy to find the coordinates in the new basis. So there must be some systematic way of doing it instead of guessing. And this is exactly what the change of coordinate matrix is used for. We denote the change of coordinate matrix by Q, and its columns are exactly the coordinates of the new basis vectors, that is, the vectors from beta prime written in the old basis in the basis beta. In our case, this was the new basis, and these are exactly the columns of the matrix Q. Let us take our example. This was our vector in the old basis, 4, 2, and we figured out that this can be written as a linear combination of the new basis vector. I have written it here. And now my question to you is, can you rewrite this expression using the matrix Q? Think about matrix vector multiplication. Think about it, and then we'll continue. Notice that these are the new coordinates in beta prime, and these are the columns of Q. That means that this is a linear combination of the columns of Q with the coefficients equal to the coordinates of this vector, and that is nothing else but Q multiplied by the coordinates of V in beta prime. We started here and we ended up here. And therefore, Q is called change of coordinate matrix from beta prime to beta. Let us now look at the general definition. Q is change of coordinate matrix from beta prime to beta when beta is one basis and beta prime is another basis, and columns of Q are nothing else but the vectors from the basis beta prime written down in the basis beta. Then we have the general relation that the coordinates of vector v in the basis beta is q multiplied by the coordinates of v in the basis beta prime for any vector v in the vector space. When we look at this expression, then our conclusion is that matrix Q changes the coordinates in the new basis beta prime back to the coordinates in the old basis beta by this expression. You can ask yourself, this is probably not exactly what we wanted. We wanted the other way around, change the coordinates in beta to the coordinates in beta prime. Plus, if you look at this definition, then you may say, this actually doesn't look at all like definition, and in fact it is not, it's a statement. If strictly speaking, definition ends here, and you can ask yourself why the statement is true in general. And these questions we are going to answer by connecting this matrix Q to a linear transformation. Here I summarized what we have so far. There was example in R2 with these two bases. We have constructed matrix Q and we figured out that this relation holds. And then we defined the change of coordinate matrix, and the column J of this matrix is a vector Vj from the basis beta prime written in the coordinates of the basis beta. Recall that any matrix can be seen as the matrix of some linear transformation. The same should, of course, apply to the matrix Q. We must be able to interpret Q as the matrix of some transformation from one basis to another basis. Let us recall how the column of the matrix of linear transformation appears. First, we take vector G from the basis beta 1. Then, to this vector, we apply the transformation T. And then we write the coordinates of the result in the basis beta 2, which is this basis. Now, when we look back at our Q, what will be beta 1, what will be T, and what will be beta 2? Can you answer this question? It is not maybe very obvious, but think about it and then we will continue. Let us look what is the column J of Q. It is defined here in the definition. We take vector J from beta prime, exactly as we do here. Therefore, we can write here beta prime. And what we do next, we kind of skip this step because we don't do anything to this basis vector. And we just write its coordinates in beta. This is identical to this definition, therefore the second basis here is beta. And the question is, what kind of transformation is here? And point is that here in between, we didn't do anything, we didn't change the vector. Luckily, we have the transformation that doesn't change the vectors, and that is the identity transformation I, where V denotes that it is a transformation from space V to space V itself. We conclude that our matrix Q is nothing else but the matrix of the identity transformation from the basis beta prime to the basis beta. Now that we know the relation between the change of coordinate matrix and the linear transformation, we can apply all our knowledge on linear transformations to derive the properties of this matrix. And that is done in the theorem 2.22. Here beta and beta prime are ordered bases for V, and Q is the change of coordinate matrix. Then first thing that we can conclude is Q is invertible, because the identity transformation is invertible. And the second is that V beta, which is nothing else but the identity transformation applied to V and written in the basis beta can be computed as the matrix of this transformation multiplied by the coordinates in the beta prime, and therefore this identity holds that the coordinates in beta are q times the coordinates in beta prime. Let us look at these implications. Here, this vector v is simply equal to identity transformations of itself, and this equality holds because of the matrix representation of the linear transformation, which we looked at in the theorem 2.14. And by the definition, this matrix Q is simply that matrix. We can now see how helpful it was to interpret Q in terms of linear transformations, because now we could use our knowledge on linear transformations to actually prove this intuitive identity. And now we are ready to answer the other question: how can we find the coordinates in beta prime if we know the coordinates in beta? The result follows directly from both A and B. And my question to you is, can you, by looking at B and A, write down the formula for V beta prime? Think about it and then we'll continue. It follows from B that we have this identity and from A that Q is invertible, so we can multiply both sides by the inverse of Q. And of course, by the definition of the inverse, this is equal to the identity matrix, so we can conclude that this is equal to V beta prime. We started here and we ended here, so we can conclude that V beta prime is Q inverse times V beta. We conclude that Q inverse is a change of coordinate matrix from beta to beta prime as we want it, and we can also write it in terms of the linear transformation, only this time the basis will be swept. In practice, if we want to use this formula, we will have to invert the matrix Q, and we will learn algorithms how to do that. Nevertheless, it is true that matrix Q is usually easier to write, and if you want this transition from old coordinates to new, then there is some work involved in inverting this matrix Q. I hope that it was clear what change of coordinate matrix is, how to compute it, how to use it, and what it has to do with linear transformations. Thank you very much for your attention.